Ông quỳ cho. Ông đừng ra bắc cả. Mình to cái chấm là ca này thế bị thì sạm là ca. Sạm là ca này thay ní ông chấm ra. Nâng vừa sạm là ca mình to sẽ đập tới cây cam sạ xây ít xến. Nâng chập đầu mình sẽ đập sạ cây cam đầu mình đang rập rập ní để mình là dân niêm PTC CP
២៤៤ក្លាមជីសកម្មភាពលោកអែមហុយឡារីការអភិសិដ្ឋានភិបវត្តមានអត្តវត្តមានភិគីនិងបុគ្គលដែលអញ្ញមរះក៏អញ្ជើញឲ្យចូលរួមនៅក្នុងកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពថ្ងៃនេះសូមគោរពលោកធានសម្រាប់សវនាការថ្ងៃនេះក្លាមជីក៏សម្គាល់ឃើញថាគ្រប់ភិគីទាំងអស់នៃរឿងក្តីនេះមានវត្តមាន ដោយលោកស្នើសុំលះបងសិទ្ធមានវត្តមានដោយផ្ទាល់ពីបន្ទុកសវនាការលិខិតលះបងសិទ្ធរបស់លោកឌុនជាបានប្រកល់ដល់ក្លាមជីរួចហើយសាក់សីដែលនឹងត្រូវផ្ដល់សេចក្តីកម្មបញ្ចប់នៅថ្ងៃនេះគឺលោកអ៊ិតសេនលោកមានវត្តមានរួចហើយនៅក្នុងបន្ទុកសវនាការនេះនៅថ្ងៃនេះដែរមានដើមបណ្ដឹងរដ្ឋវិមួយរូបដែលមានហាសនាម
2CCP2420 មិនអាចចង់អារម្មណ៍បានយូរនឹងដើម្បីមានលទ្ធភាពចូលរួមសកម្មភាពនៅថ្ងៃខាងមុខឲ្យមានប្រសិទ្ធភាពរួមសំលះបងសិទ្ធចូលរួមនឹងមានវត្តមានដែលផ្ទាល់ក្នុងបន្ទប់សកម្មភាពនៅថ្ងៃទី8ខែកញ្ញាឆ្នាំ2015បានឃើញកំណត់ហេតុពិនិត្យសុខភាពជូនជប់ចោតនួនជាដែលធ្វើឡើងដោយគ្រូពេទ្យប្រចាំការពិនិត្យព្យាបាលថែទាំសុខភាពជូនជប់ចោតនៅអវតកចុះថ្ងៃទី8ខែកញ្ញាឆ្នាំ2015បានកត់សម្គាល់ពីស្ថានភាពសុខភាពរបស់ជូនជប านหนึ่งประดาลอนุสาธาสมองยมเรอนญาตอายลูกนุนชีโจร่วมตามนานกันตำนากาสำนากาปีบรรทุกขังกรอมซาสนามการนี้ไอเลมูลธานีหนึ่งโยงตามมรรยาทในวิเทียนแปดสมุยปรามในวิเทียนไตขนงอวตโกองยมเรอนญาตอายลูกนุนชีโจร่วมตามนานกันตำนากาสำนากาปียมง่ายปีบรรทุกคมครวนมวยทันตกรอมซาสนามการนี้ตามที่อุปกรณ์สตู้สำหรับอย่าเปลี่ยนสำนากาเป็นมวยไทยนี้ประกอบอ้อยบกเล็กในสตู้ช่วยประปอนสตู้สำหรับจนจบจอดนุนชีอาจจะร่วมในตามร้านกิจกรรมการสำนักการปีจมง่ายตามระยะประปอนสตู้สำหรับกิจกรรมการสำนักการสำหรับไงนี่เดี๋ยวประต่อตอนนี้อเมริกาบริการจุนเตอร์กรมสหมิตรบริการเพียงแค่ใดดังใบมีนอกาส่วนดาวจะบวกสะใสรูปนี้ให้ตะบูนี้ประกอบบริการจุนเตอร์กรมสหมิตรบริการเพียงแค่ใดลูกนุนชีสมเชิญ
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning.
Some of the local teams, Chief Sue, local side, Chow Krom.
Good morning, Mr. Witness.
Chief Sue,
I would like to ask you some questions this morning. First, I would like to ask you a question about your family. Before the Khmer Rouge.Took over power in your village and in your district. Did you have family living in Kampong Chnang, Phur Sat, Takiu, or Kampot? Did you know at the time anything about Chang communities in those areas before the Khmer Rouge came?
No, 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 no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, ออนตอนไอ้เป็นหลังตอนก็ไม่คอมตอนจอลออนตอนไอ้ได้ในธรรมดา
But my question was, before they came, did you know anybody from Cham communities in those areas?
មានបងប្អូនចាមរស់នៅក្នុងតំបន់ទាំងនោះដែរទេ
មាន មានច្រើន មានច្រើន ខ្ញុំពេលមានមនុស្សច្រើនទៀត នៅគ្រប់គ្នា គ្រប់ផ្ទះ ផ្ទះច្រើនដែរពេលហ្នឹង
I think something went wrong with the translation, possibly. My question was, did you know anybody living in Kampong Chnam, Pursat, Takiu, or Kampot? Any Cham living there?
Ta dang tham mien bong pon Cham ru nu ti nu te.
Nyom dang da nai nai chan nai pong chnang pot. Bat nu mong ai nyom dang tham pom Cham nai nu dai pan nai nyom dal tau khong nong.
Very well, thank you. Mr. Witness, I'm not entirely clear as to which year you said the Khmer Rouge took over. Was it in
1971 or 1973?72ហ្នឹងខ្ញុំនៅហ៊ាននៅហ៊ានព្រោះ73គេបាច់ស្លាហ៊ានអត់ឲ្យហ៊ានទេខ្ញុំពុកនៅហ៊ានពេលហ្នឹង73តឹងអត់ឲ្យហ៊ានដែរខ្មែរក៏មិនឲ្យហ៊ានអ៊ីស្លាមក៏មិនឲ្យហ៊ានគេបាច
់ from that period and the years before
ចាប់ពីអំឡុងពេលនោះមកនឹងឆ្នាំមុនលោកមានស្គាល់មនុស្សម្នាក់ឈ្មោះសុសម៉ាន់ទេ
អត់ស្គាល់អត់ខ្ញុំអត់ស្គាល់សុសម៉ាន់សុសម៉ាន់ទៅសុសម៉ាន់ឯងអត់ស្គាល់
I'm referring to someone who I think was the father of a person called Mak Lee.
ឪពុករបស់បរិសម្នាក់ឈ្មោះម៉ាត់លី
ម៉ាត់លីនឹងគាត់ធ្វើការឯងកូនម៉ាត់លីគាត់ម៉ាត់លីគាត់ធ្វើការអង្គភាព
Let me start with the father of Mat Lee. Do you know who the father of Mat Lee was? របស់
Mat Lee សិនតើលោកស្គាល់ថាឪពុករបស់ Mat Lee ឈ្មោះអ្វីទេ
Mat Lee នឹងឈ្មោះតោម៉ាណាតោម៉ានធ្វើការខាងអង្គភាពហ្នឹងទៅនៅបូព៌ាហ្នឹងតោម៉ានគេថាហៅតោម៉ាន
I will ask my questions maybe a little bit simpler. Do you remember the father of Mat Lee?
Lok skol opok robos Mat Lee te?
Mat gol Mat Lee. Kot nang o nau phom pel le ma nau phom khao de nyo ot gol.
Do you know what the role was of Mat Lee?
លោកដឹងថា
in the Khmer Rouge movement
ក្នុងរបបខ្មែរក្រហមលោក Mat Lee នេះមានតួនាទីអ្វីដែរទេលោកដឹងទេ
លោក Mat Lee គាត់ធ្វើក្តាប់ទីហានដែរកាលនោះកាល73ហ្នឹងកាត់ដាប់ខាមជាមួយតោម៉ានដែរឃើញទៅណាធានតាមគាត់ដែរមិនដឹងថាក្រអីធ្វើមកងារអីខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងដែរបានតែឃើញតែហាននៅជាមួយគាត់ដែរជាមួយតោម៉ានអីនោះ
Do you remember whether Mat Li at the time was encouraging people from Kampong Cham to join the revolution?
No, Kampong Cham, Kampong Cham, or Chol Room, Chimuin, and Chalana Paddy Watman Day?
Well, young man, I've been Chol Kunong Paddy Watman.
Is it correct that Mat Li was a Cham himself?
Mat Li khlun kot ptol le ko chi chon chit Cham dai.
Ba, chon chit Cham dai. Nong Mat Li.
Yesterday, Mr. Witness, you spoke about measures taken by the Khmer Rouge as of 1973. You talked about Cham people not being allowed to have prayers. Women's hair were cut. They weren't allowed to speak Cham language. You were, in fact, forbidden to practice religion.
គាត់អត់មាននិយាយរឿងនឹងទេមានគាត់តែក្រៅពីនឹងគេគាត់និយាយរឿងសាសនានឹងបាត់បានគាត់អត់ឃើញនិយាយបានគាត់រួមជាមួយគ្នាធ្វើការជាមួយគ្នាបានរឿងបាត់គាត់អត់ដែលលឺថាដែរបានគ្រឺគេថាឬក្រៅពីនោះគឺគេមុខងារគេក្រៅពីនោះគេថាបានគាត់អត់លឺថាដែរមើលឮថាបាត់បងប្អូនអ៊ីស្លាមនឹងទេ
Who was it then that ordered these measures?
ដាក់វិធានការទាំងនេះបញ្ជាពីលើមកឲ្យធានភូមិធានក្រុមនឹងជានឹងគាត់មកពីណានេះថាមកពីអង្គការពីលើមកបញ្ជាឲ្យតាមភូមិតាមភូមិនឹងឲ្យមេក្រុមនឹងធានភូមិនឹងមកឲ្យបាត់
Wasn't Mat Li himself, in fact, upper level?
Mat Li khlun kot ptol ni chi thnak lœ dai rư ko ot te?
Sak thai ma toan hloy top. Som chœy tha prinya rong antra chiet.
Thank you, Mr. President. I think Council should ask a more specific question about his position. We know from his interview he was a member of a district committee. Some people might interpret that as upper level, some might not. So I think Council should be more specific in his question.
I think we're always speaking, Mr. President, about upper level here, without ever feeling the need to be specific. However, I will rephrase my question. Do you know the position of Mat Li, Mr. Witness?
លោកដឹងថាមាត់លីពេលនោះមានតួនាទីធ្វើអ្វីទេខ្ញុំដឹងថាតួនាទីស្អីស្អីទេបាទគាត់ថាដាប់មកបោភីអានឹងគាត់ជាមួយនឹងគាត់តោកម៉ានហ្នឹងគាត់ឃើញចេះហានទៅណាទៅតាមគាត់ដែរនឹងមុខងារមុខអីខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងពេលនោះខ្ញុំគាត់សូនៅខាងពេលនេះនៅសូននៅ នៅខាងនោះជួជួនេះជួគេហៅអីជួទួស្រែសុកស្រែខាងលឿនេះខាងសុកក្បែរសុកអីសុកបុលខ្មុំទឹងសូននៅភំពេលមកធ្វើផ្ទះនៅសម្រាប់អំពិលទេមកម្ដងយាម
Have you ever heard late at a later stage, maybe, that Mat Li was appointed in
1976 as a member of standing committee the National Assembly.
ខ្ញុំដឹងបាទខ្ញុំដឹងតើគាត់បាននៅក្នុងសភាដែរខ្ញុំដឹងតើគាត់តស៊ូ
Let me move on. Mr. Witness, yesterday you spoke about demonstrations in 1973 or 1974 because of the measures that were taken against your religion. Is it correct that after these demonstrations you were arrested and detained at Khmer Security Center?
បាទអញ្ចឹងមែនខ្ញុំគ្រោះថ្នាក់ពេលនោះខ្ញុំគូឈើក្រោយពីបះបោវិញគូឈើខ្ញុំកាប់កាប់មួយគេចោតថាខ្ញុំអ្នកកាប់គូលោពួកគេដាក់ស្បត់ទៅយកទៅដាក់គុកគុកឆ្មានហ្មងជូនទៅគុកគុកឆ្មានហ្មងគេអត់ថាគូឈើទេថាគូកាប់យើងកាប់គូកាប់គូអត់ឈើ
How were you treated at Krokchmar Security Center?
Beaten.ឃើញគេផ្សេងផ្សេងគេទៅបាបច្រើនណាស់ខ្ញុំអត់ចង់មើលទេវាដាក់ខ្នោះសួរចម្លើយពីទៅក្រោយសួរចម្លើយវាយខាងក្រោយបន្ទីគុកហ្នឹងបាទខ្ញុំអត់ទាន់វាយតែចាំមើលសិនវាចាំមើលតាមជាក់ស្ដែងសិនអត់ទាន់វាយដំអីទេខ្ញុំ
Do you know where the Krokchmar Security Center was? Part of the district of Krokchmar?
Or whether it was part of
the sector
into which Krokchmar belonged?
Krokchmar belonged to the district.ពីខំនោះ4ជាន់គេអ្នកទោសដេកដាក់ខ្នោះជើងលើនៅស្រែកស្រែកហល់ថ្ងៃហល់យប់ឃើញនៅស្រែកនឹងដាក់ទំនោតោះទោសអីដែរពីលើនឹងណែនលើផ្ទះខាងលើខំណែននឹងក៏ទោសអីទោសអីខ្ញុំមិនដឹងដែរ
do you recallTo which sector Krokchmar belonged? What was the number of the sector to which district that you lived in belonged?
Ta srok dai rok lok ro nou ni chumnoh oy dambon na muay dai lok dang te.
Srok Krokchmar kot chen dai tang pi pum tria pung traiពីពងត្រៃមកពងត្រៃមករហូតដល់កាខ្នងចំណោះនំមិញម៉ាយកទៅដាក់គុកនំគុឆ្មានំ
Let me assist you because I don't have that much time, Mr. Alexander. This was Krokchmar district part of region or sector, rather, 21.
Krokchmar, chumnoh oy dambon 21 men rư?
Man. Man. Nung da man. Krokchmar.
Do you know who after the liberation in April 75
was chief of sector 21?
Does the name Chan ring a bell?
Chưa bao giờ lực chung một nôm lại chung một chan này lục nực khơi chung một chan này thế.
Nhớ bớt còn nực khơi nực một chan nông chung một nực khơi sao? Đừng còn nơi nào còn đứng.
Do you know who was in charge in Sector 21 of economics, administration,
education, and
organization? Nhóm khởi cái đập vụ đấy nó bắt đầu khởi bằng mệt say nâng à nhóm khởi từ mò khởi từ nẹt nâng cả bên đó nhóm ăn ăn cơm ăn khởi từ bằng mệt say nâng đập bên lưng bài khom nữa.
Maybe I will assist you a bit.
Phải chỉ khi nhóm trâu chui lộc
khá hai. Somebody who was in charge as of these functions in July 75. Someone with the name
Ot Bun Chun. Chum Ot Bun Chun. Ot Bun Chun. Ot
Have you ever heard of somebody with that name in the present-day context? Someone who is presently a senator?
Ok Bun Chun? Nek Dai Chia Samachik Pratsiphia Chumuh Ok Bun Chun. Lok Skol De?
Ot Skol Lok Ot Skol.
Let me go back to the village level.
Cop Sat, who was he? We thanak phum bun ma dong chmu cop sat. Cop sat ni chi neak na dae
va cop sat ni ke neak thoe phthien phum pe long pe tang na pe chumlu chap mnu no cop sat kot thoe phthien phum pe long Cột hói bên chìa ai xây xây chủ cho ai nâng. Bên chìa bị lừa mà, bị ông ca bị lừa mà. Cột có hộp đấy, cột lạch kì.
Was Cop Sat a charm himself?
Ta Cop Sat khuôn cột to lắm, chỉ chun chạp, chỉ chun chít chạm đài rư cơ ọt đi.
Cột con chít chít chạm đấy được nhom đấy còn cột khai về thợ thiền phom khai về bên chè cái ói gì chưa mui cái này còn hộp đấy khai cái ban ban và man ngay với cái chạm vô từ đáy luôn mày không chạm từ vài trò đáy luôn từ ban và man khai
Have you ever heard of someone with the name of Meng Hun?
Lúc tôi lập lưu mà nó mình đã chứ mua mê như hôn đại tế.
Mình hôn nơi bị khối mà nó mình hôn nó thơ sân đi sọc cái chậm vô tới đại bàn và màn khá cái chậm đặt làn chỗ bà vô tới đại vô tới bài trò là mình hôn. Mà cái nhóm khang cái nhóm khó chứ mà mình hay mình và nó cầu lừa đằng mấy nhân sang nhau nhau mày nhìn thời gian thì rộng không bao nằng cột nó chậm nữa do chun nữa từ vài trò là.
Have you ever heard of a man named Les Kassem?
Lok dai lu so brom neak chmuh Les Kassem dai te?
Les Kassem ni ot kol. Ma nau phom pel de ma ot kol ma nau phom sang ni nang. Ni ot kol le Les Kassem.
That's a good question, Mr. Witness. I wanted to ask you that question.
Let me now ask you a general question about the period 74-75.
Do you know whether at that time
the
Cham movement existed, which had as in its intention to create a state within the state, a Cham state? Do you know anything about it? Phuro Champa? Does that ring a bell? I'm not quite sure if it's translated properly.
Phuro Champa.
Yes, it's Phuro Champa.
Phuro Champa. Phuro Champa. Phuro Champa.
Did you know at the time anybody who was active in the movement to create the Champa state within Cambodia?
No, ក្នុងការបង្កើតរដ្ឋចាមមួយនៅក្នុងប្រទេសកម្ពុជាដែរទេ
សូមជួយលោកក្រុមសមាគមឡាវែង
Oui, Maître Copé, pour les besoins du transcript, est-ce que vous pourriez épeler le nom du mouvement dont vous faisiez état? Je peux comprendre Phuro Champa, mais je ne suis pas sûr d'avoir bien compris de quoi il s'agissait.
F-U-L-R-O, Phuro Champa.
Sauf erreur de ma part, le Phuro, c'est en rapport avec des races opprimées, le Front uni de libération des races opprimées. Est-ce à cela que vous faites référence?
I'm happy to guide you where I have it from. E3/387, document E3/387. It's a statement of Uk Bun Chun in English, ERN 00350206, French 0044-1419, and Khmer 003-79487. This movement, I will quote, intended to create a state within the state because the Cham Muslims wished to occupy Cambodia territory on the eastern bank of the Mekong River to central Annam to create a state. This was according to their confessions. They had an organization, Phuro Champa, under the leadership of Sabun Leskazi in Phnom Penh.
Excusez-moi, est-ce que Phuro est un acronyme? Est-ce que c'est un nom à part entière? Oui, que je suis un peu perdu.
It is in his statement spelled in capital letters, F-U-L-R-O.
F-U-L-R-O.
Donc on peut supposer que c'est un acronyme.
If we would hear this particular individual as a witness here, and I'm sure he'd be able to explain. I don't know. I presume so. So you haven't heard of Full Row Champa, is that, that's correct, Mr. Witness?
Full Row Champa ni chi chmuh tram trou te.
Sa thai ma ton chloi tom. Jeung tha me tvi tha prinya rong antra chien.
Thank you, Mr. President. Just a couple of observations. I think Council should be clear about the time period he's asking about. In response to your question to Judge Laverne, this was not some secret covert thing going on during Khmer Rouge. This was an open political organization, but it was in the pre-1975 time period. So he should be clear about what time period he's asking about. My understanding is that there was a Full Row Champa that was part of a political organization related to Cham, and later on that became a part of a broader organization related to ethnic minorities called Full Row.
I think the prosecution is giving evidence. I'm just reading the next excerpt from the statement of someone who was, in fact, as of July 1975, Deputy Secretary of Sector 21. He is referring to Full Row, so I think if it was an open organization, then possibly the witness would have heard of it. But I presume, Mr. Witness, that you haven't heard of it. I would like to ask you something about a second Cham movement called Kabal Sa. Have you ever heard of this?
Nó đai lứ nhóm dây mốc copy nơi mốc nó miễn đai lứ đấy hướng chẳng.
Let me ask you in general terms. Quote unquote rebellious Cham movements.
Cholana to su Tolana to su bah bao robot Cham. Look, that lưu thế.
Đây lưu đây. Bạn đã có phần mùi nữa à? Bạn đã có phần mùi cái bộ dụt nâng mai khom nâng à? Bạn bạn đã có phần nâng à? Cái đầu nó đây lưu đấy. Bốn chết bạm.
Very well, let's move there. Yesterday you were asked questions about this rebellion in Khmer. You yourself were not there, but you had an in-law who gave you information. Do you know anything about what caused the crackdown of that rebellion?
Miền mù là hai cái đèn nòng ao miền cà bọc crab cho là nani tế ta miền là vậy cả lãng môn pe thì vô bị chuyên tam tôi xâm làm
cái này pe lăng du hỏi khát khát du hỏi khát ai cũng ai phơi ai cũng ai phơi mà có phật lăng mà có phật vì ăn phom thâm nhang cũng ai thâm nhang bu cũng ai bu
Have you ever heard the story that 28 Khmer Rouge cadres were chopped to death by local people?
Cặp ngọc tích thì lục đại lừ đấy đường nâng.
Dạ thanh bản toàn loài tóm. Xong chơi hình thập đến nhà rồng ăn trả chiến.
Council is leading the witness, and he's leading with a completely different account than I think every one of us have read about this incident. So if he's seized upon some misaccount of this, he at least should be quoting it so we know where this information is coming from. The accounts of this rebellion talk about one person soldier being attacked, not
28.
Let me not focus on 28. Have you ever heard?
Hello, khnyom bomplech chao chua rueng 28
nak ni. Khnyom ban han tha 28 nak men. Many Khmer Rouge cadres being chopped to death by junk.
Tlop lu so tha mien kamapibal khmai krom
trou ban jam samlap chao de. Chao krom fan nong me tevi ka pia kdai dambei panha patte chat rak keu tha lok su samnu oi ban me oi mien mulathan oi ban chbas lo pantech ban te. Đối đã miền ca sản xong phí xã bệ nhà anh chân.
The 28 is, I will get back to you, it's either coming from Keenan or Poncho.
Mình đang tham mau bị biến cái nền đất bằng số thế bên là chúng luôn mà phải mình bấy chúng đừng bắt đầu tam cõi.
Chúng people chopped a sub-district driver to death is coming from bàn
cặp cam mà bị bà
là không mình người ta sập chân hơn. General and I will ask tam chấm lại được bao nhiêu whether he knows anything about killing
Khmer Rouge cadres by jump.
Và nhóm khơi tròn đấy, nhóm khăn khơi lưu xâm lạp, đang bà mát, đang đặt xâm lạp đây, vụ dư thề này, cặp xâm lạp đấy, đang bà mát nhẹ, nhóm ọt đấng đấy, cái nhóm đợi một bên lắm. Và này, bọn cái nhóm bẹp đang bà mát đây, thả xâm lạp đây, đang xâm lạp bàn mát, nhóm ọt đấng.
You just said 77, but do you in fact mean 1975?
Ta nang lok ngai no knong chnam 1975 rư ko yang na?
Mun nang 75. Mun yang 75 ba ba goi nang ban chumlie 75 nang mong. Ha chumlie. Ba ba goi nang chumlie nang 75.
But what did your in-law tell you specifically about killing of Khmer Rouge cadres on Phong Kong? How did this happen? Who was involved? How many people died?
Xâm lạp dư thịa, nó dư thịa bánh xâm lạp. Mình nói nó phải chi chân ọt, ọt dư thịa ọt, ọt bánh thế. Còn ọt thơ bạp thế. Chi chân ọt, ọt to, ọt chăng nâng còn. Bạn thì nè nó chăng từ mục, từ mục dư thịa nó bàn dư thịa bánh xâm lạp. Chi chân nó đồng, ọt thơ bạp thế.
Let me move on to how the rebellion was cracked down. Do you know which forces were involved in the crackdown of the Khopal rebellion? Were these district forces or were these sector forces?
Nếu bọn đăng đá lên những ban khen chun đi sọc mỏ còn trộm như thế nữa chun đi sọc mỏ một triềm ba bò có phò lắm triềm chung bình có phò lắm.
Have you heard of military forces with heavy artillery coming from the rubber plantations in the south, having different kinds of uniforms, carrying heavy weapons, and that they were involved in the cracking down of the Khmer rebellion.
ແລະបានចូលរួមក្នុងការបង្ក្រាបការបះបោនៅកោះផលហ្នឹងទេខ្ញុំអត់ឃើញតលទេបានលើពួកខ្ញុំសាយដែរឃើញតែកំភ្លើងធំនៅត្រៀមកន្លែងសាច់មុខផ្សាយហ្នឹងបានខ្ញុំអត់ឃើញតលទេឃើញតែពួកនឹងត្រៀមកំភ្លើងធំក្រៅផ្សាយហ្នឹង
What do you remember about this artillery?
Cho lok cham avai khlas pi reung ka phleung thom ne.
Yo cham ne. Ban ot khoy ot khoy tu te te kan ne triem ne ban ne ka phleung toich ne ne banh te mo banh pu ka phol lang. Kan ne triem oi klaik pi na phom na mo chuay. Bên hiện ông tới đây phom soi ông hiện tới tròn chập tròn chập tròn ông hiện từ
But do you remember or your maybe your in-law remembered people soldiers wearing military uniforms and carrying heavy artillery
norm អាវុធធុនធ្ងន់មកជាមួយទេ
សាស្ត្រាចារ្យមហាតនឆ្លើយតប សំជួយថាបញ្ញារងអន្តរជាតិ
Thank you Mr. President again if council wants to try to refresh and use a document that talks about these soldiers in uniforms he should reference the material because I believe he's now mixing up the Khmer and the Sai King rebellions two different events so he's shaking his head but none of us would have to debate this if you would cite the document when you wish to put evidence to a witness
I'm asking a general question to the witness, Mr. President, whether he remembers or his in-law remembers people wearing military uniforms, indicating that these would be regiment or sector forces rather than district forces.
ឬក៏ យ៉ាង ម៉េច ហើយ អ្នក ដែល មក នោះ គឺ ជា កម្លាំង របស់ តំបន់ ឬក៏ តំបន់ របស់ ថ្នាក់ ស្រុក
Mr. President, Council shouldn't be testifying about the significance of military uniforms. Again, if he has information he wishes to present to the court that's part of the record, he should cite it. He's leading here, he's testifying himself.
Again, I'm not testifying at all. I'm asking
whether he knows anything about the people
Shooting that's my question. ទាំងអស់នោះដែលប្រើប្រាស់កំភ្លើងធំប្រើប្រាស់អីហ្នឹងនេះជាសំណួររបស់ខ្ញុំ
Mr. Witness, do you remember anything about the soldiers being involved in the military attack
on Khmer? វាយប្រហារបង្ក្រាបការបះបោនៅកោះផលនេះ
ខ្ញុំ កាន់តែ ឃើញ កណោត មក តាម កណោត តាម កណោត ពី ខាង ក្រៅ មក ចូល បាល់ កោះ ខល ហ្នឹង ប៉ន្តែ ក៏ ភ្លើង ភ្លើង ចូល ឃើញតែ ប៉ុណ្ណឹង ឃើញ បាញ់ គ្នា ហ្នឹង ទៀម ពី ថ្ងៃ មក ចូល កោះ ខល ហ្នឹង
Do you have any knowledge of artillery? Do you know anything about how many millimeters mortars were at the time?
Look, đăng tha miền cặp phleung thbal nung ya proman millimeter ay proman millimeter look đăng thế.
Không ăn đăng thế, không ăn tốt, look ăn đăng. Ăn đăng ta proman nhiều ăn đăng.
Have you ever heard of Battalion 55 of the Sector 21 Regiment?
លោកប្រធានពេលសំណួរអំបញ្ញមិញនេះតាមរយៈអ្នកបកប្រែជាភាសាបារាំងគាត់ស្ដាប់ឮដើមឃ្លាទេលោកប្រធានលោកបើចើកូពេតាំងទំនួលចុងក្រោយបើលោកថាជំនុំបន្តទៀតពីព្រោះការបកប្រែភាសាហ្នឹងមិនច្បាស់លាស់ទេព្រោះបាត់ពាក្យមួយចំនួនដើមដំបូងដោយសារការបកប្រែមិនទាន់
I certainly will, Mr. President. Mr. Witness, have you ever heard of Battalion 55 of the Sector 21
Regiment?
I shall give you the name of one of its commanding officers, and I will ask you whether you know this name.
Hun Sen,
the present Prime Minister.
Hun Sen.
Do you know him?
I don't know him.
Have you ever heard whether he, as a commanding officer, was involved in the crackdown of the rebellion of Kopal?
Again,
Mr. President, I have no objection to the question if it's based on something and not just counsel's theories or wishes. So if he wants to put this question, please cite the basis for it so we all know. He shouldn't just be making things up in the courtroom.
Well,
the basis is actually someone who worked with prosecution
for quite a while.
លោកមេធាវីកូពេសូមលោកបង្ហាញនៅមូលដ្ឋាននៃឯកសារដែលមាននៅក្នុងសំណុំរឿងដែលអង្គជំរះបានកំណត់យកជាភស្តុតាងជាឯកសារភស្តុតាងសម្រាប់ធូរដេញដោលមកធ្វើជាមូលដ្ឋានដកស្រង់ធ្វើជាមូលដ្ឋានក្នុងការតាំងសំណួររបស់លោកទេ
If you insist, Mr. President, of course I will provide you the basis of my questions. It is E347.3, English ERN 0108627, which describes indeed the attack on Sui Kling and Kopal.
The
position which is being put forward there is that the attack was done by Battalion 55, led by Commanding Officer Hun Sen. And I'm trying to establish whether the crackdown was done by the region or rather by the district. So that's
I'm trying to do that.
Mr. Kopik, can you repeat the reference? I'm sorry, pardon. Est-ce que vous pouvez répéter les références?
That is correct.
E347,
so not E3 slash, but
E347.3.
It is a human rights watch report on page 20, English ERN, as I said, 010860207. The attack on Svay Kling and Kopal is being described as executed by Battalion 55 of Sector 21. So that's where I have my information from.
Maître Coupé, est-ce que par hasard vous êtes au courant d'une décision de la Chambre concernant ce document?
No.
Vous êtes certain? Il n'y a jamais eu de demande pour que ce document soit versé au débat et la Chambre n'est jamais prononcée
dessus? I think the Khieu Samphan team did, that's why I know we didn't, but the Khieu Samphan team filed the request.
Yeah, donc, Monsieur Coppé, je parle sous le
contrôle des partis, il me semble que le rapport Human Rights
Watch
explique à cette partie-là n'a pas été admise au dossier.
Well, again, as in other situations, you made me explain where my knowledge is coming from. I was asking questions about which military forces were involved in Kopal, and it seems that it was the forces led by the present Prime Minister who were involved. The information is coming from Steve Hedder, which is, I'm sure, the author of this report, and who worked for the prosecution
for quite a while.
We heard an impassioned speech yesterday about how people need to rely on the investigation. This rebellion was investigated. I've been searching for references to Battalion 55, and if there's a basis for the question, that's fine, but counsel should move this document into evidence if he thinks it's reliable. It's a Human Rights Watch report. Human Rights Watch obviously was not at Kopal in 1975, so the real issue is what is the source of this information. And when counsel tries to present matters in this way and stand up in this courtroom and assert something as a fact when there's nothing in the investigation about it and it comes from a document that's not been put in evidence, these proceedings are distorted. So we would have no objection if they move this into evidence, but we need to know what the actual source of this evidence is, if this proceeding is going to be meaningful.
As I said, the actual source is someone who is considered an expert for this court, who didn't testify as an expert, but as a witness, and who was someone who was involved in the investigation for a long time. And I have knowledge that, in fact, Steve Hedder is the author of this report, and he is making the argument that it was, in fact, Battalion 55.
Mr. President, I'm pretty sure Steve Hedder was not at Kopal in 1975. So again, the issue is, what is the source of this? I'm looking to see if Steve Hedder's name is in this. I'm looking for sources. But the reason I'm having to look now, and we have to interrupt this proceeding, is because counsel hasn't put this evidence properly before us. So I'm here in the position of having to search this document. So I think it's entirely improper the way counsel brings these matters before the court.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Je m'étais rassise. Ce que je voulais juste préciser, c'est que ce document ne fait pas partie du dossier. C'est ça le problème. Donc, ce n'est pas la question de savoir si on parle aujourd'hui de Hun Sen ou non. La question, c'est de savoir qu'aujourd'hui, encore une fois, la défense de Moon Jae-in sciemment utilise un document qui n'est pas dans le dossier et que la défense de Pyo Sang-kwang a tenté de faire admettre, selon des règles procédurales parfaitement connues de tous, ce document et que le document a été rejeté par la Chambre. Donc c'est ça le problème. Le problème ne c'est pas de savoir de qui on parle, mais de comment ce document est utilisé par la défense, alors que la défense sait sciemment que ce document n'a pas été admis au dossier.
Oui, pour les besoins du transcript et pour l'instruction de Maître Coupé, les références du mémo sont E347-1. La partie pertinente concerne le chapitre 2 du rapport de Human Rights Watch, en particulier les paragraphes 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour à tous. J'ai simplement une demande de clarification auprès de la Chambre, puisque j'avais cru comprendre des décisions précédentes, y compris dans le procès 02-1, que la question de l'origine du document et de la citation du document se posait lorsqu'on entendait confronter le témoin à la barre à un document précis, mais qu'à partir du moment où on ne présentait pas de document, nous avions la liberté de poser les questions que nous souhaitions. Donc, je ne comprends pas pourquoi tout d'un coup, il faudrait que chaque question que la défense pose soit basée essentiellement sur un document. Nous avons la liberté de poser des questions qui nous semblent utiles dans le cadre de la défense de nos clients. Pourquoi, si on n'entend pas opposer un document particulier au témoin, pourquoi devrions-nous avoir à baser toutes nos questions sur un document? Donc là, c'est une clarification parce que ça ne me semble pas être, en tout cas la position développée par Monsieur le coprocureur ne me semble pas en rapport avec la jurisprudence de la Chambre en la matière.
If I may respond, the reason is you're leading the witness if you don't have some basis. You can't just stand up in court and make an assertion that Hun Sen was part of an attack without some evidence. And I'm reading this now. There is no cited evidence here. There's a reference, unspecified interview by an academic without even identifying the source. So for counsel to stand up here and make these assertions without a proper evidentiary record, he's leading the witness. Yesterday, both of you stood up and objected when I asked this witness how many Cham people lived in his own district. Now you want him to be an expert on the entire structure of the East Zone.
It's a pathetic and shameful attempt to cut the fence off of trying to find out what
really...
សូមអរគុណលោកប្រធានខ្ញុំក៏សូមធ្វើការកោតសម្គាល់ទៅនឹងចំណុចនឹងដែរដោយសារថាកន្លងមកឲ្យខាងខ្ញុំជាដើមប្រដឹងរបស់វេនីហ្នឹងក៏ត្រូវបានឲ្យនៅរាល់ពេលដែលតាំងសំណួរក៏ខាងមេធាវីនៃការពីក្តីក៏ធ្លាប់ឲ្យសួររកប្រភពនេះដែរអញ្ចឹងហើយខ្ញុំក៏ស្នើឲ្យកន្លងមកហ្នឹងក៏ខាងអង្គជំនុំជម្រះក៏ស្នើសូមឲ្យពួកខ្ញុំហ្នឹងផ្ដល់ប្រភពនៃការដែលខ្ញុំសួរសំណួរមួយមួយទៅផ្ដល់ប្រភពជូនទៅ
On the record, Mr. President, what's happening here is an attempt to avoid evidence which might incriminate present government members as perpetrators of the actual genocides if there were any in 75. So I think it is perfectly appropriate to find out what happened in 75, especially in Tra Village, which is about to fall. The defense is perfectly entitled to find out what happened in 75 and whether Uk Bun Chun and Hun Sen were involved in the killings.
I'm sorry to rise again, but I cannot let that be unresponded to. No one here is trying to do that. You are perfectly entitled to pursue that. You need to do it by proper evidentiary means. You cannot just make up things in the courtroom. So feel free to prove that. We have no objection. You need to do it by proper means of evidence, Mr. President. That's our position, not that you should be precluded from doing this.
As said, it's Steve Hedder who's implying this, and you know him very well.
There's nothing about Steve Hedder in this document. He's making that up.
I don't have any evidence that Steve Hedder said that he was saying that.
Well, it cannot come as a great surprise. I mean, this is how criminal proceedings work. If you want to confront the party with something, if you put forward an allegation, you have to cite the basis for this. If the basis is a document which hasn't been admitted during the proceedings or actually specifically rejected, as in this case, find another basis or move on.
And
that's exactly what I didn't do, because I know this is going to happen in this trying to hide the truth of what really happened. Something I would, of course, do in any other court, Mr. President, but I will move on.
Mr.
Witness, do you know how many people were killed at Koh Phong and Sui Kling?
Đừng có xâm lập, đừng có xâm lập mà nhiều mà đừng.
Is it correct that hundreds of Cham were massacred by East Song forces?
Bạn thâm lạp bạn đăng bà mạng nẹ bà mạng nẹ nhóm bạn đăng đều nhóm đã buồn lực tiết đầy đầm bền lắm. Bạn đăng bà thâm lạp bạn thâm lạp bà mạng. Bạn đăng chung nôn bà mạng bạn đăng.
There was another massacre in 75.
Miền ca xâm lạp bằng kia mùi tiết nộp nông chân nằm một bọn cùng buồn rồi chất
sắp bà
răm. Nâu phù mùi nữ ta trầm trâu đại tế.
Again, counsel is leading, and again, I think he's got his information mixed up. There was another incident in Svai Kling in 75 in Tria, it was 1978. If he has some other information, he should be specific. He shouldn't stand up and lead the witness with incorrect information.
Please read sources, Mr. Prosecutor. I have it from Kiernan, who's quoting Phong Chau, describing massacre, which was executed in pretty much the same way as described yesterday by this witness. And exposed them along the banks of the Mekong.
Phong Chau, page 153.
So I'm trying to figure out whether this massacre in Tree, that witness described yesterday, wasn't actually in 78, but rather in
75.
Mr. President, I have no objection. Again, he should read the document first, ask the witnesses if he's familiar with an event in Tria Village in 1975, but he shouldn't stand up and suggest that what he just read is in any way similar to what the witness described as happening in 1978 in Tria Village. They're completely different. So he shouldn't be characterizing and leading. If he wants to present and ask about what happened in Tria in 1975, go ahead.
Is the witness, do you know whether there was a massacre of Cham being killed, thrown in the river in 75 November? We know for a fact that this French person that I was referring to, François Phong Chau, wrote his book in 76. So at the time he didn't know what was going to happen later, so I think we can be convinced that it was in 75. Have you never heard any stories about the cruelties that I just described?
Again, counsel is leading. He's misstating the evidence. This witness has described one event that took place in Tria in 1978. This book describes a completely different event in 1975. And he shouldn't be leading and trying to mischaracterize the evidence when he's asking questions here. This is utter deceit.
អធិជនទៅនីតិវិធីដើម្បីឲ្យវាទៅមុខលោកមេលោកថាប្រញ្ញារងអន្តរជាតិលោកបង្ហាញចំហរច្បាស់លាស់ទៅចំទាស់នឹងមូលហេតុចំទាស់នឹងច្បាស់លាស់ទៅដើម្បីឲ្យយើងរះសម្រេចឲ្យវាទៅមុខទៀតណាទី
Thank you, Mr. President. The ground is that counsel is leading the witness. He's leading and suggesting to him that event in 1978 was the same as a different event in 1975. That is a leading question.
I don't think it was a question. It was a possible theory that this witness might be very afraid of telling what happened in Tron Village in 75 and rather shifted to 78. But my question, the very factual question, was whether he knows anything of mass atrocities, which are in certain details quite similar as to what he described yesterday. That's my question. Does he know of any mass atrocities in November 75 in Tron Village?
ដឹកគំនូរនេះខ្ញុំអត់យល់សោះអត់ដាក់អត់បានអាចឆ្លើយទេណាមកឆ្លើយតបទៅនោះមិនដែលខ្លួនលោកមិនយល់ទេណាបាទឥឡូវនេះដល់ពេលសម្រាប់ហើយអង្គភាពប្រកាសសម្រាប់ចាប់ពេលនេះទៅទៅរហូតដល់ម៉ោង 10 កន្លែងផ្ដោតសកម្មនៅក្នុងបន្ទប់សាមណការនេះនៅវេលាម៉ោង 10 កន្លះសូមអញ្ជើញគាត់មកកាន់កន្លែងផ្ដោតសកម្មនៅក្នុងបន្ទប់សាមណការនេះនៅវេលាម៉ោង 10 កន្លះសូមអញ្ជើញចុះសូមអញ្ជើញក្រោកឈរ